Welcome to Smart Acceler. This video is about VLOOKUP versus DGET function. So now if I want to check, so this is my previous video. I would like to show you that this was the column which was done by a technique, and this is a normal column which was done as normal an average Excel user. So I would not, I was not able to tell you in the last video, so please refer to my videos on column and columns and row and rows. So I'm going to show you that if I delete this area, and you can see that this has become into a negative balances, but this has been remaining in the same serial amount. So this is a technique which has been used. So please refer to my previous video on those things. So coming to this video, I'm going to show you that I don't want to use advanced filters, and if I want to check the record one by one, so I have a data validation, and I want to take items. I don't want to use an advanced filter, or I don't want to use the filters. So if I want to see certain things on my list, so how we can use? So normally we used to have a VLOOKUP formula. This is my record list, and how we use is a VLOOKUP is a VLOOKUP. Open the parentheses, and this is the area, and we go to the database and Control Shift End and Control Shift Down, and I can hit an F4 to log the cell values, and the column index I want is as a second column, and I'm going to do is 2. And I want an exact match, so I'll be doing zero or false. So you can see that the record is in such this way, and if I change this, so you can see the record is changing now. So actually if I want to move this, and I want to, so you can see it's incoming an error. So every time I have to go and keep on changing the records, and if you see, I have to log the cells in the beginning. If you want to do this, I have to log. I have to keep a F4 over here and make this change the cell reference. And now again, if I do this, it keeps on moving the same one because we have to change the column reference each time. So this is 3. And when I come here, I have to make this into 4. And so on. So this is a bit of hassle, you know, you have to always keep on changing the things. So now if you have a big database, and if you want to have some records for your use, and if you want to use the same reference in some other area where you can have limited things, so this is a bit hectic procedure. You keep on changing things. So what we can do is we can have a DGET formula. DGET formula works in a certain way. It gets a DGET, DGET. You open the parenthesis, and now you see you can have a database. It's not a array or a range. So if you have a database, you need to have all the elements from the beginning. So it will be like from the top value, you have to select the database considers in Control Shift area, or in the right side, and Control Shift Down. So you can select the whole area, or you can have a table also if you have a table record. And now we can log the cells, and if you make this into an absolute reference, and then so now the amazing part of this is asking the field. So what is a field is the data which is in the top. So this is going to be your field, and I want to keep this handy because when I move down, I want this field to be moving, and I want to get the criteria. So when I put the criteria, I can select this as my criteria. So anyhow, I'm going to get an error, but I'll be removing this to just show you, and I'm going to log this cells and close the parentheses and hit enter. Anyhow, I've got an error because this is a mixture I just wanted to remove. So now you can see you have got that, but you can avoid the hassle of getting the things. So you can, if you don't need to keep on changing the track, so automatically the things got cleared. So whatever data if you want, you can see, and you can within fraction of seconds you can get the things on board. So I hope you got this video useful, but the drawback is you can't have this for multiple ranges, or you can't have this for an array. So it just for simple data you can have this function, which is going to save a lot of time and energy. And I hope you got this idea. And we have many things like VLOOKUP, index match, DGET, switch, and many other formulas and indirect and others. So I hope you like this video, and please subscribe to my channel. Please hit the bell icon, and next videos I'll be sharing, I'll be starting on VBA projects. So see you there. Thanks for watching.